Hello, good evening, good afternoon, good morning. My name is Mo Abudu, and I am the Chief Executive Officer of the EbonyLife Group. And the EbonyLife Group consists of EbonyLife Studios, EbonyLife Media, the EbonyLife Creative Academy, and EbonyLife Place. And EbonyLife Place is where we're shooting this piece today, and it's home to EbonyLife Cinemas, it's home to the White Orchid Hotel, it's home to Turaka, our rooftop restaurant, and it's also home to Ginger Lagos, our Asian fusion restaurant as well. So yes, that is who I am. My journey has been an exciting one. I started, you know, my media career after I just turned 40. So a few people felt I was sort of having a life, you know, a midlife crisis, which I wasn't. I just knew instinctively that telling our stories and having a strong narrative was going to be extremely important to us as Nigerians, as Africans, as a continent, as a global Black individual. And I knew that I had to do something. And that something for me was starting my talk show, which became the anchor for so many, many more things. And, you know, it commenced with Moments with Mo, and then came a couple of other shows that I produced. And then the big one was obviously EbonyLife Television, and then came EbonyLife Films, to the point where we are now in 2021. We are the first African production company to have signed a multiple deal with Netflix. We are also the first African production company to have about 30 international projects in development. So we are extremely excited about the future and telling authentic African stories to a global audience. I think the opportunities for investment are massive. I mean, the inroads are basically, we're still at a grassroots level. The opportunities that we have experienced in the last few years are based on the fact that there is an emergence, there is a consciousness, there is a need to tell our stories. Story is story. It doesn't matter where in the world you come from. People just want a narrative that they can relate to and they can buy into. And I think commercially, what's happened around the world is that storytelling has become something whereby it's become the same, the same, the same. And everybody now wants a sense of freshness to the stories that they want to be told. I mean, if we take, for example, now the new Netflix blockbuster, Squid Game, which was made for a local Korean audience, has now become a global phenomenon simply because it's original, simply because it's authentic. And it wasn't even made in English language. You can watch it obviously with subtitles or a dub, but it tells you the importance of story, story, story. So I think that the opportunities for investment are huge. We haven't begun to touch the tip of the iceberg. And we're happy to be one of the production companies and studios that's at the forefront of building and telling the African narrative and empowering many in front of the screen and behind the screen and telling our stories and pushing that out there. It's only just the beginning. So the commercial numbers are going to make so much sense for audiences around the world. We're excited to be, you know, at the forefront. And when we look at what's happening globally with all the streamers, they all need to have a percentage of content that comes from the continent. So therefore, it's the opportunities are just are massive. Investors need to look at the African creative sector as a viable market because it is a market that hasn't been explored. We know that, you know, all banks, all financial institutions have an emerging market desk. We all know that the return on investment is always way higher when it's in an emerging market. And this is still an emerging market. It is the right time for investors to say, I want to be in on this journey. I want to be a part of this journey because it's all still so new and still so fresh. It's the right time to be at it and to be in it. Well, I think it speaks for itself that there is a future to African content being successful within our continent because we want to see stories that we can relate to. It's important for me to see me. It's important for others to see me, to have respect for me, to understand my tradition, to understand my ways and my nuances, to understand my stories that have never been told. So I think definitely there's an appetite for great and good storytelling. And for us at EbonyLife, we have built four key genres that we think the world is going to buy into. There's Afro history, which is going back in time and exploring all those incredible stories like the Dahomey Warriors with our partnership with Sony. Then there's Afro impact, which is looking at things that are impactful, that impact us as a continent and those around the world. And that would, if we look at a project like Oloture, that was the most watched Nigerian film on Netflix in 2020, again, it tells you the importance of impactful storytelling, like human trafficking. The third genre is Afropolitan, which is telling day-to-day stories, like the wedding party, you know, Chief Daddy, Your Excellency. It's dealing with my day-to-day reality. You know, these stories get told by studios around the world. So why is my day-to-day story less important than your day-to-day story? And the fourth is Afrofuturism. So if you take a story like Nigeria 2099, which is a partnership with AMC, it talks about a scarcity of resources in the continent and the fight for those resources. And we've seen that happen time and time again. It's just that this story is now set in 2099 in a futuristic society. We know the world is bought into the sci-fi genre. And it's important that we can also, you know, have our own rightful place in that storytelling as well. My advice is take what I have done. It's to invest in content development. It's to invest in storytelling. It's to invest in building the team. It's to invest in pitching these stories to global studios around the world. It's to get them to buy in. And it doesn't happen overnight. You know, it's a continual conversation. It's about being in the room and telling those stories all the time. And, you know, they are biting, which is why I can sit here and say to you that we do have 30 international projects in development. With our partners. We do have a whole slate with Netflix. So I can sit here and say that because we have done it and we are doing it. My response to that is capacity building. You know, and again, EbonyLife is at the forefront of doing this for our continent and doing this for Nigeria and doing this for Lagos. So during the time of the administration's agenda building and trying to identify the projects that would have benefit for Lagos was the need for capacity building. And the Creative Academy, the EbonyLife Creative Academy, was an idea that we had had, and we had had discussions with several governments, but nobody had the foresight to buy into it. But this particular administration did. We launched the Academy in March 2021. We have had two graduations of 240 students so far. Every year, we're training 480 students in producing, in script writing, in directing, in cinematography, in sound and audio post-production, and they're going out into the workforce. Now, what gives me the greatest joy is that one of our students, Genoviva Ume, who came in as an acting student, is now going to be in a major Netflix production, you know, and it tells you that there are no limits to what can happen with the right amount of training. So the future is capacity building and developing that skills force, and that will definitely take us into the global space that we need to be a part of.
Africa's creative industries have found new global appeal due to the uptake in streaming services as well. In 2020, Nollywood generated 1 million jobs and more than $7 billion for the Nigerian economy.
Yes, streaming platforms are expected to reach 5 million African consumers by the end of the year. In this next conversation, IFC investment analyst Ngozi Okwenny will have a conversation with Hamid Ibrahim, production designer for Disney Plus's new animated series, Owaju.